All right. We are back. It is Tametsi time. What is the situation? There's 100 levels. Dark levels in blue text we actually completed. Dark levels with white text we fucked up, but then, like, we did complete. And then we have not those. Everything that's not that we have not completed. I don't remember where I left off. I think I left off stuck. I think a bunch of these were just like, we're just fucking stuck. Now, this looks like there's a lot of room to do stuff. I think this may have been where we left off. Been a while. Hold on. I'm gonna open. The last Tametsi stream. And I'm gonna see what the last thing I did here was. Tametsi. Oh shit, also, let's get Mojito in here. Da! And a little mask. Yeah, all right, okay. How the hell do you spell Tametsi? It's got a T, that's all I need to know. All right. Okay, what did we do? Oh no, we got stuck on flotation. Oof, spent 20 minutes on this bitch and got stuck. Then went over to Hecagon. Oh my god, what a funny name. All right. Well, now hold on. Then. Which one is Hecagon? You're Hecagon. Okay. And what the hell were we doing at the end of Hecagon? Timer was at 37 minutes. Oh my god. Come on, bro. What's the last thing you actually uncovered? Oh my god. Oh, there we go. Okay, so like the top left corner. All right, top left corner of Hecagon. The last things we cleared were up here. It's good to know that just in case that helps us. I don't think it's going to. Okay, so we're already at 40 minutes. Why can't you be at home playing Balatro? Shit, I still didn't check that out. Was there just there? I assume there wasn't just a demo for Next Fest, right? Is it like actually a game that was released? Hypnotically satisfying deck builder where you play illegal poker hands. That's fun. Yeah, I think Big Guy also mentioned it. Overwhelmingly positive feedback. Damn. Maybe I do need to play this game. The fact that it's just poker makes me kind of be like, eh. Ooh, this screenshot's pretty sweet though. There was a demo and it was released 5 hours ago. Oh shit. Cool. No, don't. Oh my god, there's like booster packs. Oh no, that makes me want it more. Hold on, take me back to the cool screenshot. This looks fucking cool. The Joker arts are cool. The fucking card back is cool. The poker roguelike. Oh my god. All right, we need to maybe the demo is still available. Should it not just like say that clearly here? The Control F demo does not appear. What if we search Balatro demo? Nope. Okay, so the demo was just for Next Fest, probably. I don't know what the idea with that is. There's a lot of games that very specifically only release demos during Next Fest. Like, shouldn't you just leave it up? Isn't it like work to take it down? Like, you did all that work to have there be a demo, and that could help sell your game. Whatever. I don't know. It's not my fucking life. It's more like Rummy, to be honest. I have played Rummy. It's been a long time. I don't remember the difference. Either way, that seems like it's worth a try. $15 is a little steep for something I might find boring. I was hoping there would just be a demo. I don't know. Maybe I could pirate a copy of it, and if it's good, buy it. All right, so let's give this board just a little bit of time, and then we'll go on to another one. And just a quick check, how many boards? We have two boards that we have unlocked but not seen, and that's it. Okay. So at the end, before, I was looking at these two lines, and they are like so close to being useful, but not quite yet, as far as I can tell. Everything I say has the asterisk of as far as I can tell. Then beyond that, I'm not really sure where I should be trying to act. Looks like we've already used this as much as we can for now. About. We're very close. Because there's a bomb here. And this three, oh no, this 3S spot's down here, okay. Okay, so we're only kind of close. There are two bombs. God, in all of this. Oh my God, and this. Holy shit, dude. All right. So it's mostly not bombs. That's mostly not helpful. Then let's see, is there any other process of elimination stuff to do with the other spaces? Like, this three just has too many spots. I have two bombs down here. I could just have one. Too much going on. Too easy. Okay. Too easy for there to not be bombs in here. And then same with this two. They could just be in these spots. All right. Then this, we just don't have a lot of information. So we can try these horizontal guys real quick. Not enough information. Oh, I fucking love this song. Oh? Okay, well, that's interesting. We have a solvable thing. Oh, shit. We have a good solvable thing that might lead to a bunch of other solvable things. Okay, so this one has a bomb here, which solves this one. And then will that potentially lead to a cascade of information that just uncovers all of these rows? Columns? They're sideways, so I don't know what they are. Let's find out. Or this did nothing. Well, it did something, so we know you're a bomb. Now we know you. Oh, and you. Wait, for real? Yeah, okay, yeah. Okay. I guess that doesn't actually change a whole lot. Is that really a dead end at this point already? Now we know there's just one bomb here. I don't remember if we knew that before. Let's just follow this through. We know one's there, and then we know there's one here. We know there's one. Whoops, that's the wrong color. One here. Okay, no, we already knew this information. So that's not actually helpful. Damn, it's really not helpful. Okay. Wow, I totally thought that would lead to more. I got excited. Art. Okay. Oh shoot, what's the button for the editor again? It's a button I can press. It's D. Okay. All right. Should refresh myself about the situation with B. There's only 4 bombs left in B. We already know there's one here, and there's one here, and then there's one here. So we are very close to being able to use that information, but not quite. So there's either a bomb here or there's one here. Okay. And then A has 11 and C has 11. Wish I could toggle the colorblind information on and off. I absolutely don't need the letters here. The colors are different enough. All right, we'll go back to what we were doing with the horizontal lines. What you got for me, gang? Don't think we have enough information to act on this. About you. No, very little information. And then you're 7, so like either everything's a bomb or we can't do anything. No. All right. Probably the same here. We uncovered a few spaces. We already know where the 2 bombs are in here, and we have everything else marked or exposed. Yeah. Then 3 in here. Oh, I bet there's some way to use these. Nah, these 2 pieces of information. So, yeah, I guess we could potentially use them together because we know there's like a bomb in each of these spots, and that's 5. Oh, no, yeah, then we know there's one there. Okay, so there's no extra information to get. Oh my god. Oh, that's so lame. Holy shit. Ah, nope. I thought I had the editor open. So we also know there's one in here. Is it helpful at all to look at it like that? Like, no. Maybe. And like for this too, there's one here. Doesn't really help you do anything as far as I can see. Okay, can't see anything to do with that situation. Or this 2. Well. So there's one bomb in here. At least. There could be a second. Maybe we can prove no. Oh my god, then these are the only spots where they can be anything going on. Everything up here is done. Okay, yeah, that's potentially We could act, but I don't see it. I don't see it. Looks so close to being useful. And everything can't be close to being useful. There has to be one spot where there's useful info. Huh, one thing I've never really stopped to check, actually, to learn, and maybe I should have. Do the question marks have to be a number? I assume they can be a zero. That's worth looking up. Can question mark be zero? It's really funny when you Google search something and Google bolds words that it is like, yeah, you searched for this. No, I didn't. I did not search for number Z. I searched, can question mark be zero, Tametsi. Google, you get dumber every day. All right. Well, I do not see an answer. Darn. Is there a section that just has the rules listed somewhere? Here? Nope. Alright. The next one's called buttons. Shadow boxes, buttons. For some reason, that makes me think of the joke in How I Met Your Mother where they're like, we'll make a bar and call it puzzles. Why is it called puzzles? That's the puzzle. It's fucking stupid. Worth a snort, though. God, what could we possibly do then? What kind of logic is on the board? I missed that little thing over here that led to some information being revealed here. Then we were able to mark these. So maybe there's something we can do in this area. So now that this is a 2, does that mean anything for us? Not really. The most that this 3 could have shared with it was already 2. It's not like the fact that it was a 4 and now knocked down to a 2 means it limits the sharing with 3. It just feels like there's something in here going on that I need to figure out. The logic required for this is so crazy. All right, we're at 13 minutes. I'll give you to 20 hecagon, and then we're going on to another level. You open this window to see my reaction to the honks. Wow, there was some loud honking outside. Yeah, when I hear people honking like that, I wonder like, what the fuck are they doing? To me, it sounded like somebody honked because somebody else was in the way, and then someone else like honked back. To be like, fuck you. You couldn't hear on the mic though, yeah. This mic is lovely. She's a good microphone. It was worth the investment. Also nice to be able to crunch on chips while we're playing, or popcorn while we're playing Baldur's Gate and not have to worry about it. Fucking sweet. How do I solve you, game? What do you want from me? Okay, I'm gonna like really scrutinize this fucking area. So we know that there's a bomb here. Means we have one here. Can we do anything with the fact that there's also one here? I guess that tells us they're offset. That tells us that it's either like a bomb here and a bomb here, or a bomb here and a bomb here. So we could just do like proof by contradiction, follow them through. I think that's like the best idea. So one there on either side wouldn't matter. We'd have one and one, none here. So if we have none there, then both of these are bombs. Solves this too. Means that this has to be safe. We come up to this too, and there would just be a bomb on either side. I gotta remember my notation. The white dots are bombs. We do a dark line with a white dot. And then actually this wouldn't even be the case. This has to be safe, so actually that has to be a bomb. What's your deal, song? Talus. Cool. Dude, I just realized I actually restarted my computer, which means I have to relaunch the song monitoring app. Sarah? There we go. All right, cool. Okay, so we'd have to have this cluster. Can we then, we would then even further have more information that this has to be over here because there's already three bombs. And then this would have to be down here. Okay, so all of that looks perfectly possible. So no contradiction was found like this. It would be lovely if we try it the other way and we find a contradiction. It is nice that so many things locked into place, so it does kind of feel like we might find a contradiction. Okay, so the heart of it, it all started here. We're gonna swap this. Bomb here and bomb here. So what flows from that? Is this less deterministic? I think so. So, nope. Remember your notation, sir. Okay, so we'd have a situation like that, then this B has to be safe. We already knew that. That's gotta be safe. Yeah, we have a wider range of unknown. That's a pain. Okay, so that's way harder to do any kind of proof by contradiction here. It's still potentially possible, but it's like hypotheticals on top of hypotheticals, and that's really lame. Well, I think that might mean it's time to go check on a different one. Oops, still in the editor. All right, yeah. We're almost at 20 minutes. Let's check out Shadowbox. And at the very least, you know, hopefully I'll be able to do something. Okay, so what is a shadow box? It's like a little thing you put a thing in. Why is it actually called a shadow box? I know people like put stuff in shadow boxes. It also means to spar with an imaginary opponent. Right, shadow boxing, sure. Oh, that's also what this could mean, but I feel like it's more likely a case with a protective, transparent front used for displaying jewelry, coins, or other small objects. Oh. Okay, still don't know why it's called a shadow box, but sure. All right, so we have 100 mines. We have 24 in A and 23 in B. Let's go. Can we get row and column info of just a few? Okay. It's a good place to start. Oh, weird thing to think about is there's a bunch of spots where you get information about B or about A because of how they're all set up. Oh, that one's a question mark, boo. Like that's 12 bombs out of B. Interesting, I don't think that'll be useful. But it's interesting. Okay, where the fuck can we start? Probably like the four. Because, diagonals count. So the four is a shared space with one, and the only spots in the unshared space number up to three. So then, of course, you need a single bomb in the shared space. So then you know, bomb, bomb, bomb. There's a bomb up here that completes the one. So we clear that away. And this one has a bomb in one of those. So does this one. So we'll clear those away. Functionally, since there's a bomb in here, that makes this guy a one. It's not that useful. All right. Thought it was for a second. One bomb in here, looking at this three, means we need those to both be bombs. Okay. Oh, we have a 1-2 down here. Bomb here means we have one here. Not that useful. Oh, wait, it is for this one. Fucking duh. Okay. And so then that's gotta be a bomb. Nice. Cool. And then if we have a bomb here, that's safe. Let's see, three has to have a bomb out of the shared space, then it's got two bombs in the shared space with this two, so that's safe. We have a 1-1 right here. This two just needs bombs there. Hey, okay. Oh my god, so loud. Too many things being revealed. This feels like it couldn't possibly be hard now. I've been wrong before. Be cool to, try to like codify the process of designing things to look easy, but to actually be really hard. And the reverse, probably. In fact, the reverse would probably be better for a puzzle game. like things that look really hard, but then they're easy, and then people solve them and are like, oh my god, I'm so smart. This too only has two spots for bombs. There's a bomb to the left or right of this one. Okay. Oh my god, I'm so weirdly excited to have movement like Pokemon in Godot. Gotta get that shit locked in and get my camera angle working out. And I guess it's like time to start with like puzzle functionality, maybe even combat too. But before combat, because I want the game to transition from real time into combat when you get, I don't know, when a hostile presence is alerted to your presence, or when you are alerted to their presence, I want you to have the ability to go into turn-based mode. Feels like I would need to get the, like, the simulation running. Little Rattatas running around and Charmanders running around. It sounds like a fun but daunting thing to tackle. I guess it's weird if somebody's watching this on YouTube. Just before this was developing a game in the Godot engine. Or the Godot engine, if you are so inclined to mispronounce things. Shit, do I actually just need to jump into another one of these spots? So many question marks. Yeah, shit, maybe I do. Do you have? So we started off with a nice, like a 1 and a 4 that were next to each other. I don't think there's anything quite as generous in here. The burp attack. Better than a cough attack. What about? Let's do a little bookkeeping. Where are we at with A? It's like there's 5 bombs here. Yeah, we just can't get that much info. 2 more down here. Yeah. Alright, we'll keep looking for a good in. We do have all these numbers on the edges that might be good. So what could we do with that? Like knocks this 3 down to a 2, but that's not really helpful. What about these bees? No. Not seeing anything. If I don't see anything soon, we'll check out column and row info. And then a 4 and a 2 next to each other just doesn't really work. But maybe with extra info it could. Okay. Oh, this 1 and this 2. Okay, great. So So there can't be more than one bomb in here. And so there's at most one bomb. And that would mean the two would need another bomb over here. And then the other thing to think is like, oh, could the two put both bombs here? Like, no, it can't because of this one. So then that means there is not only at most one bomb here, there's at least one bomb here because you can only put one bomb here. So then now we know these are both just true. Neither one is an at least situation or an at most. They're both just true. That's safe. And then these are safe. Anything else that we get out of that? Not immediately. Okay, go ahead and clear it. Right, this two needs a bomb here. There's only one bomb in here. This one. Okay. Now I think we're in a situation where maybe we could do something with the four and the two, not quite. Right. That feeder's back on. Okay, so we at least know there's a bomb here. What can we follow through? We know there's a bomb in here. Oh, now we have a four and a one functionally. Here, because the one that's in here means there's one bomb left for the two. So there's one bomb in here, which means this four needs three bombs up there. That's nice. That's not actually that helpful. Doesn't really lead anywhere right now. Okay. Well, it was still cool, I guess. Okay. Done everything we can up here with that information? Maybe. Okay, yeah, I don't immediately see anywhere else to go. The fucking question mark's just ruining the flow of, like, logic grouping from one area to the next is so lame. I wonder if the levels were designed and then systematically you go in and put question marks in spots to make it so they're harder to solve. I bet this board would be a joke without question marks. Mojito is snoring. Wah. This guy's quite low. Two bombs in this whole row. But it's really not helpful yet. Like, there could be one over here, but maybe not. There could easily be two in here, but maybe not. Okay. So, not using that yet. Obviously, I was wrong. There's still room for this board to be difficult. I guess I'm just, like, underestimating the sheer volume of question marks. Oh, this is a good song, too. Thank you. So three is in an interesting position. All three of these could be bombs.
That's backwards. There we go.
If this guy was safe. Come on, game. What do you got? Show me your openings. Okay, what about B? Still can't figure out anything about B. There's 14 bombs left, 3 up here. Yeah, it's not enough. What about column info like this? Really annoying that there could be a bomb down here, but maybe not. Dang, it'd be nice if we could prove there had to be one bomb in here. I don't think we can, though. Well, So we could try like a proof by contradiction thing. So like there might be two bombs here. Solve this guy. There'd be no bombs here, which would mean another bomb in here. Dang, there might actually be something to that. So we have to put 4 bombs in this column. So if we put 1 down here, then we only have 3 to place. Can we avoid putting 1 in here? Yeah, you could put like something like that easily. Okay, all right. What a tease. Little checkerboard areas with the bees. We can't follow much because of the question marks. So we can't like use a bunch of different group logic to move up into the top of the board. Yeah, like I know there's a bomb here and then that's where that ends. There's 2 in here. Oh, no, there could be some over here. Okay, all right. All right. Fuck. God damn. Over here, we'd have a single bomb. So this is a bomb in here, and then that's it. That's as far as we get because of the question mark. We have two over here. Which means one here. Because of the three. Which means this two needs one right there. Ooh, we got one thing. Wow. Do I have the Owen Wilson wow?
Wow.
It was a little loud. Owen, you're a bit loud, buddy. What about this guy? It's just like too hard to work with. We know there's one bomb, two of them, another here, so that's three. Oh, actually, shit. It's kind of like you're like running out of space at that point. So maybe everything else is bombs. Stupid question mark. So then like max here, you could have two. Okay, yeah. Too much unknown space. Bad idea. Teamworm, you might be pocket dialing, buddy. Pocket typing. Oh my god, that was from a while ago. That's funny. I just totally missed that message. Oh, that was intentional? Oh shit. Sorry, I missed your message. Was it when I was complaining about all the question marks? That would make sense. I was talking about designing with question marks. Right. Yeah, you might have added a few too many question marks in because that's far too difficult of a sentence. But I'm guessing it's they designed it by taking them, putting them. I don't know. No, I don't know. The first part was pretty easy to guess, though. Or you only had a sentence up to buy. Nice. That's kind of what I was thinking. Why's this game gotta be so hard? I hope there's some fucking subreddit somewhere with fucking smarty pants assholes that like get puzzle game recommendations from each other, because they're like, God, just everybody else is so dumb. It sucks to play puzzle games when you're a genius because they're not hard. They never challenge you. And hopefully they like Tametsi. Because, man, it's just like too hard. Being stuck out of the flow state of solving for a really long time becomes not fun. Aliens Rock is like the king of puzzle games. Are they a streamer? It's a cool name. Their top thing is, if you search for them, is a Balatro playthrough. They're a streamer and a YouTuber for sure. Popular from Polybridge. Is that one of the like bridge construction physics games? Those are fucking fun. It is nice. I played the Portal one recently, and it was okay. It was on sale at some point, and I bought it and then just never played it. Team Worm, if you see a spot to go, you could give me a hint, huh? You beat the Portal one when it was on Game Pass. Nice. It's always fun to have the like Gladys level of smarmy commentary while you're playing any kind of game. Polybridge is a bit more realistic with physics, but gets wackier. Ooh, that is tempting. That sounds intriguing. Okay, wait. I didn't finish looking at this column and gave up, but like, dude, there's at least two bombs right there. That's fucking crazy. Overlaps with this one, so you actually don't get that much more info. You know there's actually one extra bomb there. Okay, all right. Oh, it's still not enough. Fucking, it's not enough. Yeah. Damn, man. Tuck in, Momo. It's gonna be a long hour of not solving any puzzles. Fuck, bruh. Phone had a notification. Tried to dismiss it. I accidentally left my phone on. Okay, you know there's something. We haven't used column or row information yet. What about this guy? Way the fuck down here. Can we do something with that? You're a one, so then you're a one. You're a two. Hey. I think I can place a mine in the bottom row with the 2-2-3. Damn, okay. But you're not even certain, oh my god. But you've beaten this! Damn it. Did you cheat too, Team Worm? You casting aspersions on people in the Discord? Maybe you cheated too, huh? Maybe that's why you know they cheated, because you're a cheater. I thought you said, maybe I was wrong, but I thought you said you had beaten all 100 levels. That you finished the ones that you hadn't beaten when I was when I restarted. Maybe not. No? Oh, damn. I thought you said you did complete them. Well, shit. So we can get up to 5. Now... maybe I'm thinking of Bam Bam. Yeah. I don't think so, because in my head, Bam Bam is like fucking stupidly good at this. Which, damn, I could use a tip from them right now. Now, this two might only have one bomb. So like there might be a bomb in here. There couldn't be two bombs in here. So like this two has at least one bomb. And then, boy, it would be great to figure out that there's another bomb down here. Because then that would be all of them. We could clear out some stuff. But yeah, let's look down here. The 223 is like a 1-2. Yeah, let's check it out. You might not be doing countdown correctly, though. Dude, it's so annoying to switch gears. Like, you're right that the countdown's absolutely helpful for this shit. It is annoying switching gears and doing, like, regular Minesweeper and then trying to come back to this. Ooh, shit. Speaking of regular Minesweeper. Tomorrow and Thursday, we got to play more of that advent calendar. But we're just gonna burn through the ones that aren't fun. We're just going to skip them. They're too hard. This one's too hard. Same with Tametsi. Too hard. Okay, so what is the shared space with the 3 and the 2? It is this region. So you're gonna hit 10k event points for friend quests, which is cool. Oh my god, I fucking totally forgot about those. Dang. You want me to just send you my friend quests and you can just like abandon them or not? It'll only have like fucking one. And it'll be worth one. Oh my god. What a way to punish me for not playing. Lame. Alright. Well, now I don't even want to play. So... so there is at least a single bomb here. There might be two. Could there be two? If there was two, then there'd be no bombs in here. Mm-mm. Then you'd need each of these to be a bomb for this 3. And then this 2, because we know it already has a bomb above it. Can't solve that. That's impossible. So. Oh, then we know that's impossible. So then there are two bombs here and one bomb here. Okay, well that means that's safe. Oh my god. All right, bro. Cool. Okay, but the thing I was trying to get at is that then this guy's a 1. And so then this whole area can only have one bomb. And then same with this whole area, it can only have one bomb because this 2 has a bomb above. So that means this 3 just has a bomb right here. But then there's more we get out of that because then we know that these bombs are actually limited. They have to be in the range that's shared with the what was a 3 and is now a 2 because... otherwise, this 2 couldn't get its bombs. So then we know these are safe. And we also know that's safe. Okay. Anything else? Oh, we also, now we have this two here, so we know that's safe. And then we know that's a bomb. All right, let's clear out the editor. Look around a little more. We now know you're a bomb. Oh. And then we know there's a bomb in here, so this two has a bomb there. I feel like I already knew that and just didn't mark it. Okay. Okay, brah. Okay. What else can we do? Is it time to use this yet? I don't think so. Yeah, there's very little information about which bombs are actually in this column. Dang. All right, well, Team Worm, your hint to look at the 2-2, the 2-3-3 situation was good. There's a big something now. Oh my god. All right. So, what did we actually change? Looking at this column might be good. But probably not. Still quite a few bees. That seems useful now that this is only one. Is there anything that I can actually do with that, though? God, all the fucking question marks. I can't carry any information up into there. Okay. The three has to have a bomb up here. Great. So then those are safe. Then what? There's one bomb in here. There's four up in here. That's not helpful. Bro, I hate these fucking question marks, man. How can I not see that that leads to anything else? Only two bombs in here? That's interesting. Not that useful. Okay. Think about this two that we revealed. You weren't wrong. You were wrong about this, the big something. Okay, I thought you might have meant this, but then it didn't lead anywhere. But all right. For sure. Even if you weren't, I want to at least scrutinize this to my satisfaction before I go hunt elsewhere. It's easy to just get like in this weird mentality where you don't really know where to go and you're just like hunting around everywhere but not thoroughly examining everything. What about this too? Would have two bombs there, then that's safe. Shit, actually, wait, could you? Because we know there's only one bomb up here. For the oh my god, well, both of those are bombs, so then that has to be safe. Oh, how did I? Oh my god, really?
Ooh.
Ooh. And then, nope, those are both bombs. Sure. And then that's a bomb. Yep, yep. Duh, we knew those. Knew those. Oh my god. Clearly I'm not in a Tametsi mindset. I almost ended the stream early because I was like, man, I'm still like kind of tired from being sick. God, especially like the last 2 days, I've just been coughing so much. It's been so long since I just had a fucking constant headache from all the coughing. Ugh. But when I was finishing up the Godot thing, I was like, you know, I'm not that tired. I want to play some fucking, I want to puzzle, bro. Puzzle me up. Clearly, I'm not ready. Oh, this bottom row is so fucking tempting. What's your deal now? We do have more info now, but I feel like it's still not enough. We know there are in fact two in here. No, we knew that before, right? It's just the carryover we don't know about yet. That's five of your damn bombs. Five of the six. Is there anything else we can kind of like suss out of here? Could be red there. Probably not. Oh, yeah, since there is only one in here. There can't be more than one, rather. Right? Because this two, one, at least one of these affects this two. So then here, you could have at most, in this spot, you couldn't have more than one. Which means here you do have one for this two. And that's all them bitches. That's six bitches. Okay. All right. You just press D to turn it on and off, buddy. Use the keyboard shortcuts. Almost clicked the wrong thing. Okay. So now we can do a little cleaning up. Solve those. Solve that. Solve that. Yeah. Okay. All right. Fuck else, bro. What the fuck else? Oh, I think we know this corner is safe. We have just like a series of like corner situations. Because if there's one in here, then there's one in here. And for this two, there's one in here. And then if we looked at this two, there's one in here. Yeah. Safe corner. Oh, it's a three. Hell yeah, buddy. Dang. Nice. clear, like an erase all button would be good. Could it be E? No, it's not E. Dang. You just everything's a bomb. Same with that. Okay. Okay. Just clearing little things out here and there. Oh shit, that was exciting. Okay. Like that was a second good little breakthrough. Okay, what do we do with what we got though? This two and three together. This three needs a bomb here because there can only be two in here. Sure. It's still quite a small thing. What else? This one, two. It's a bomb there. There is a bomb down here, so we've solved that one. And here means we would here. Not that useful. Damn, the number of bees is dwindling quite a bit. Just two in this column now. Damn. Well, there's at least one right here. Any other way to prove where any other one of them might be? I think it could just be that both of them are up there. All right, we'll just leave that for now. Probably some other little things I can hunt down. Nope, that goes nowhere. Okay. Ooh, 46 minutes already. Spicy. Be time to use the column info on the left. We know that. So essentially we're dealing with a four. So, what is the deal? We know there's two here at the very least, because this three would need two in here and it could have one here. It'll be hard to know if that's the case or not. If we could use some overlapping groups to know, like if we could figure out that this two had a bomb over here, so then there's only like one bomb here, which would mean this three would need two bombs in here. Like, oh, bro, that'd be fucking, that'd be perfect. But let's could we do something like that? Thinking no. What we have is this two and this two. Question mark is not our friend. Well, what if we tried like a proof by contradiction? So what we want is for there to be two bombs in here so we can just clear this out. So what if we tried to prove that the opposite situation can't happen? could two bombs be in here? I think so. Oh, maybe not. No, because this two. Two bombs being up here would mean that this three only needs one of these, and that's fine. It could just, the other one could be out of the shared space. So that works. This two would be satisfied by them, so then there could be no bomb here. Is that okay? This two would then have to be satisfied with bombs right there. So then we'd be in a situation like this. Yeah, because then this one can just be down here. Damn, okay, it's possible. What about? I didn't say anything about an exclamation point question mark. I just said the question mark's fucking annoying. Or stupid or something. I was mad at the question mark hanging out here. How do you do the cool exclamation point on top of the question mark? That's fucking sweet. Or do I just have a smudge on my monitor? Nah, that's definitely an exclamation point on top of a question mark. Probably like, there's probably a keyboard shortcut for it. You Google searched Interrobang and then you copy it. Okay. If I remember right, you can type an upside down question mark with like by holding Alt and pressing 168 on the number pad. Maybe there's a shortcut like that. But your way's probably better in the long run, right? Like, how often do you need the cool combo? Forgot that that's called an Interrobang. I thought the Interrobang was something slightly different. You remember looking up a bunch of those in elementary school? Yeah, somebody showed us the question mark. And then, same thing. It was just like, fucking, what else is there? And not that much cool stuff. Nothing that I thought was cool enough to memorize, at least. Damn, Tommy's chowing down. Maybe he won't come yell at me. Son of a bitch game. Okay. I feel like the answer is either in the left side or the middle side as far as where we need to progress, because we've made previous progress in these areas. Now, what can I do? Find me an in game. You accidentally left him in the utility room for the last hour. Damn, crazy pants. We need to get a little cat door for the utility room. A nice like double wall, double insulated, like double flap door. It's a little like locking mechanism. And then that way we leave it locked. Then if you're ever like busy doing stuff, but you want to let him out there, you just leave it open. Just got to make sure every time we go out, we close it. Okay. He did not pass up on bugging me. We do game. So many overlapping groups that stop being useful the moment they encounter a fucking question mark. Okay, what about that? There's a bomb here. Whoa, sir. Yeah, bro, eat that old food. Go for it. God, Thomas is such a fucking glutton. Sorry, he's a food motivated boy. Hello. Hi. You're gonna knock over my drink or step on my stream deck, so you're getting kicked out. Hi, you're so cute. Yes. It's so hard to stay mad at that boy. You pick him up and he just starts purring. He's like, oh my God, I love you so much, Dad. Just like cuddles into me, rubs against me. God damn it, you sweethearted asshole. Too stupid to know how much of an asshole you are. All right, this isn't going anywhere. Like one bomb in all of this. What even? Okay, I feel like maybe there is something with this weird situation where, like, let's say we did have a bomb here. That means no bombs here. And then this two, the only way to actually solve this would actually be that. Okay, which does mean the top is safe. Oh, and these would be safe. Okay, so what's the other option? If instead there was a bomb in here that solves the one, then no bombs here, one bomb here, and then this, because there's two bombs in the column, we need another bomb there. Now, I think that successfully tells me that these two are safe. Woo! Okay. Cool. I feel like a smart boy. No idea what to do now. Oh, Tommy's outside whining. Can we carry that information further? One bomb here and one bomb here. Then for the three. Oh, and then a bomb there, duh. Well. Oh, shit. I guess actually not necessarily. Could be that. Okay, but then, so then there's, because there's so many different ways, there's a few different ways that this could play out. And I can't actually get the information I want. We don't know the situation right here. And then that means I can't really do anything with the three. Like, we know, I guess, two bombs like that. Okay, I don't think that really goes anywhere. Damn. Okay. Ugh, I hate these little leads that lead nowhere. So hard, bro. Don't think we have enough information to work on this column yet. You gotta put those numbers somewhere. Four of them pretty much means that one of these guys is going to be solved from that. Probably this guy down here as well. Would be my guess. Oh, we seem so close to being able to figure out the situation with all the bees. The bees! Okay, so like there's a bomb here. There's one here. Ooh, and then there's two. Two's nice. There's two bombs in here. So close. It's so fucking close, bro. One bomb away from being able to not do a whole lot. We'd be able to clear out like one or two bees. Be nice though. Damn. Okay. So I feel like I've kind of looked at everything. Let's go back though. Damn, the idea of being a dev and watching people play your game sounds really fun. I could imagine the Tametsi dev watching me, judging me. It sounds fun to be him, or her, or them. Sounds like a good time. Yeah, it'd probably be even more fun to like. Like if you're the people making Hollow Knight, Team Cherry, just like have like a week where all you do at the office, you and everybody else just get together and you just like watch live streams. I guess probably recorded ones would be better so you could skip around, but it'd be fun to just like take notes, see what people liked, what they didn't like, especially with like a beloved game like that. Like, you know, it mostly would be things they liked. I think it was IGN that did devs react to speedruns. Yeah, somebody, one of the bigger game outlets did that. That shit was really fun. I can't remember what game, but there was some game that was beaten in like 10 minutes and the devs were just like flabbergasted and like happy and excited about it. Like, holy shit, what are you doing to my thing? What? I had no idea you could do this, and I made it. I've seen at least two of those. And yeah, I think you're right. It was IGN. It's a nice, like, yeah, being human's cool sometimes. Sometimes we destroy the planet. Sometimes we create cool stuff and then have fun watching people play with that stuff. Sometimes we make a stupidly hard puzzle game and people can't solve it. Everything is just like one step away. I go like almost. There's almost two bombs there, but there could be one over there. And then now that means you don't know anything about the situation. Actually, I see a way to get information that I did not have before. Okay. So there is at least one bomb here. Did I not have this information before? Maybe I did. Shit. There might just be two. I feel like I actually did do this already. Oh, we're doing it again. So, these are all, like, at leasts. Okay. So, actually, yeah, this is the information I want, then. So, since these are all at leasts, there is one here, we know that. There's at least two in here, and at least two in here, and it adds up to five. That means they're also like that. That has to be that. You couldn't actually have more because then the other spots wouldn't be fulfillable. So we know you're safe. And then also we know, because it has to be this way, then we go backwards to where we started with our hypothetical, and we know that guy's a bomb. But shit's so hard. Okay. What the fuck else does that even get me, though? Oh my god. Shit. Oh, well, we also know that this is a bomb now, so that's cool. Oh, this too. Yes. Oh. Oh. Oh, god damn it, Tametsi. I hate you, but you make me feel so good. Shit. Okay. That was sweet. That was a good moment. Okay, so now that's a bomb. Oh, yeah, this whole thing is just a fucking chain of a house of cards collapsing before me. Yeah, that's nice. Oh, wow, that was... Whew. My relationship with Tametsi is unhealthy. Definitely. I think probably my relationship with video games is, like, unhealthy in general. But then it's, like, the way I developed that unhealthy relationship was by using it to deal with other even more unhealthy relationships I had no choice but to engage in as a kid. And so then that has, I think, led me to, it's like I want to love all the games, you know? Even when they're little bastards. Or in Tametsi's case, I wouldn't describe Tametsi as being a little bastard. It's just so hard. And when you grow up good, like when you grow up obsessively playing games, you get pretty dang good at them. And not just good at them, but good at figuring out like what they want from you, what the possibilities are. So it always feels like when I was growing up, if I couldn't do a thing in a game, it usually meant that like 99% of people couldn't. So then it sort of gives me this like inflated sense of ego that I try to not allow to control me. But so when I play a game like Tametsi that's too hard, I'm like, but I fucking play all the games. I liked all the games. I should be good at this. And then I get mad. But this is still good. This is still like, that was so enjoyable. Oh my God. That was fucking. That was probably the best thing I'm gonna do all day. Oh, shit. Whew, my God, yeah, the sense of satisfaction was so palpable. Now I'm just like, what do I even do? Holy shit, okay, so we have this row, we have these two columns. We have B probably like, oh, are you B? Are you still not solvable? Can we still not know? There's two here, and then yeah, we still don't know for sure. Oh my god. All right, what else can we do? Clear that away. Nope, wrong buttons. Click erase all. Okay. Follow your notation. So if there's one bomb in here, that this is just like, who cares? There's two bombs in this area. That's not art. Not helpful. One bomb in here and then one in here could lead us to something. Dang. Dang. So what does that mean for the four? It would be great if you had a fucking another bomb in B. Then we could clear this out down here. What if we tried to proof by contradiction, you having three motherfuckers up there? I don't think we can. So we know there's a bomb here. Three's other bomb could just be in this row. Where the two and the four both have a bomb. So we could do something like that. There's a bomb down here. So then this three could only have one bomb in here, but you could easily just have another one over here that's still not part of this. It's still too difficult. All right. Well, let's get that editor back open, though. What else, though? We know before that because one bomb is here, that there are two here. I don't feel like I look. Yeah, I did not look at that. Oh, shit. Wow, could I really have done that? I could have done that like a while ago. Oh, no. Okay. Okay. I mean, well, now we know that guy's safe. And then we also know there's another bomb in here. That might be the extent of what we know. Okay, so that got me one thing. Oh well. It wasn't that useful. It was a thing to get, though. Does this go anywhere else? Now, because of where this two is, there might be zero bombs up here. But actually, real quick, while we're here, why don't I look at how many bombs are left in A? There are seven. We have four of them down here. So, holy shit, dude, there's seven bombs in here? Oh, no. Seven minus these four. There's three in here. Okay. There's three in the unmarked spot. Ooh, that was very dumb. So we can use the two right here. Know that two of them are here. So now we do know there is actually one right here. That's pretty cool. Which actually lets us know that's a bomb. And then as we go with that, it's like that. Okay, so you're a bomb, you're safe. Okay. Okay, and then we can also kind of, we can look at this too. This is a similar thing that we had to do in the top left. And then that, so then we know that this is safe. I closed the editor. Wow, I lost my nice clear. Bart. I was gonna say somebody hit me with a you blew it, and then I was like, that sounds weird. What's a different way to say that? Somebody you blew it me. Oh no, how about somebody blow me? Jesus.
You blew it.
Thanks, Team Worm. The only streamer I watch regularly, Kyle Bosman, intentionally, very intentionally says the term laying pipe as often as he can in a way that is like maybe sexual, maybe non-sexual. That's what I was obviously getting at with the blow me thing. Blow it me. Blew it me. Whatever. Okay, We know. Okay. Yeah. So if we just look at this one, and then this one, those are safe. Which means that that's actually a bomb. Hey, that's the bomb I fucking clicked. Ooh. So then that's a bomb. Now what? Oh, you're a bomb. You're safe. You're a bomb. Let's clear that out. Clear that out. We can clear you. You're a bomb. Save. Okay. Oh, we're finally at the point where we can use B. Great. Okay, there's one bomb left in B. It's right there. So those are safe. That's safe. That's a bomb. Solid. Wow, I think I'll actually get to solve this. How lovely. Okay. And so then you're safe. What the fuck else? Do we look at the column now? Shit. And there are times when things seem like they should be really obvious to me. And then because they're not immediately obvious to me, that makes me like get stuck being like, but it, should it be obvious? It should. Should it? It should. Okay. What do we actually have to work with here left? There are two bombs up here. So then like we already know that from the one. You know, there's one bomb here. Oh, that's good for the two. Yeah, duh. How did I not see that? Okay. So now we know that's safe. And then because there are three bombs in this column, this guy up here actually has to be here. And then that means that these are safe. It means that's safe and that's a bomb. Those are both bombs. Safe. Bomb. And then sure, you're at zero. Sure, so then, oh my god. Okay, so it's not like real. We fucked up, but like, it wasn't logic. Logically, I solved it. I fucked up by pressing the goddamn D key right before trying to mark a bomb. Whoa. Ooh, cool. Buttons indeed, my dude. Okay, so first of all, we gotta reset the timer. Thanks, Team Worm. I'm on it. That's sad. I don't know how big the stream delay is. It's really interesting to be watching a stream and to be able to tell how long the stream delay is based on people reacting to things. Safe timer! Damn, I wish I had like another button that just adds the same timer, but like bigger. And then I could turn it off. I could act like I thought I turned it off, but I just added another timer and then add another one and another one and another one. All right, we've got 7 minutes. Do we just end early and then save this for next time? Let's glance at it. Think about it. Oh shit, also. 2.44 seconds. Are you saying that your stream delay says that? Can you tell the delay? I feel like they should give you that info. Video games give you that info. And if it was only under video stats, no fucking way. I'm gonna be honest, Team Worm, I don't believe you're only 2.4 seconds behind. And then I know if you're responding, then it's like it's both of our delays, or it's your video delay plus a chat delay, which I would assume is the same because it's like Twitch servers, but I don't know. Type one. And then you typed one. Okay. And that could have been about 5 seconds. I'll run it back. I'll watch the VOD. We'll find out. Crazy Pants, you've told me the delay before from the same source. Oh, yeah, maybe. Maybe you have. I don't remember things. I just don't fucking... I used to remember everything. I even smoked just inordinate amounts of weed in college, and I still just fucking remembered everything. And now it's like it's all catching up with me. Ooh, latency to broadcaster is 7.25. Damn, crazy pants. And you're like right there. That's brutal. Dang. All right, well, we've wasted a decent amount of time. Let's just like eye it, feel it out. Where would we start this? A refresh would probably lower it. Yeah, sometimes it does. Regularly it does. My stream's always fucked for you. Yeah. Yeah, it's frustrating. It's also brutal. It'd be nice if like mods got like preferred latency in general to Twitch. With the idea of like I get there's only so much they could do if there's like some shitty connections between the Twitch servers and you. There's nothing they can do, but in general, it would be cool if they prioritized giving mods a good connection, just in case somebody says a racist thing. It's just that the mods could be that much faster on getting it out of there. Interesting. So there's four. Each letter, there are four different colors, and each of those colors has four different pockets. Four different buttons, probably, is how this is clearly being conceptualized. Okay. And then we get some row and column count. It's normal Minesweeper, the diagonals count. So where would we start this? We can get like group info. Oh, good question marks. Get group info and know like there's a single bomb here. Okay. Yeah, we could break in right here. We know there's no bombs above or below this one. Because there has to be a bomb above or below here. Just back it up. You got the one. There's one bomb in this whole area. Let's bring up the editor. Duh. One bomb in here. And then that means if you look at the two, then there's one bomb here. Then you look at this two, it needs another bomb. Then you look at the three I covered up, and it needs another bomb. So boom. Safe zone. All right. Hopefully I'll remember that's where we should start. I was going to say, somebody was streaming Tametsi when I went to switch the thing, the category. It was like, hey, Tametsi's got three viewers. That's the first time that's happened. Oh, shit, no, don't close that page. That's a page to remind you to read about Godot plus Rust. Yeah, somebody named C.C. Kinnison is playing Tametsi. Oh my god. Honestly, he's just like a glimpse into my future. He's
too many numbers left, and everything is colored, so nothing really useful there.
Puzzles to fill the S50 delay. Damn, PC gamer for basically as long as they've existed. What a cool dude. All right, let's raid this guy. Let me put my music back on. I just wanted to hear him. He was kind of quiet. Okay, hold on. Let's check his profile. Is there anything weird? Anything bad? You seem cool. All right. Yeah, he seems all right. All right. Great. Oh my god, the channel is intended for mature audiences. Oh my god. You might hear some curse words. All right, dudes. This is a good place to end. Tametsi has earned another week. It gets another week for sure. And let's go watch CC Kinnison do some Tametsi. Anyway, what am I doing tomorrow? Tomorrow's Pokemon. Pokemon Infinite Fusion, open a booster pack, and then we'll play some Minesweeper Advent Calendar. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, I'm excited. I'm sad I missed a week. All right. Thanks for hanging out. I'm gonna end. Do the raid. Have a good one.